Your life and my life. Watch this. The author and the finisher. Now, between the beginning, but let's put it in this way. We serve a God who is the beginning and the ending of your life and my life. So, between the beginning and the ending, all sorts of stuff will come. Problem will come. Trouble will come. Everybody? Blessings will come. All sorts of stuff will happen between the beginning and the ending. Everybody can understand that? But, in the beginning was God. And in the ending will and must be God. So that everything from point A to point B, God is aware of everything that is between. God is aware of the troubles people go through. God is aware of the problems people go through. God is aware of the lies we will face up with. God is aware of sickness we will go through. God is aware of accident we will go through. God is aware of trouble we will go through. God is aware of blessings we will go through. God is aware of cruel lovers who will hate us, we will go through. But here, what we have to do, what we have to do, we have to put our eyes on the ending, because we know that He is there from the beginning. So everything that comes from now to then, don't put your eyes on that. Don't put your eyes on the problem, on the trouble, on the this, on the that. Because watch, if you put your eyes on all the problem and this and that and that, let me tell you something. You won't have enough time to put your eyes on the ending. You won't have enough time to put your eyes on Jesus. Because so much problem will come, you will not have time to keep your focus on Jesus. And every one of you this morning know what I'm talking about. When problem comes, we seem to put our everything on the problem, and we forget about Jesus. But when the problem comes, problem I know, God said, it will come, problem will come. But the nice thing about it, problem will come, but Jesus already come. The problem solver already come. He's already here. So whatever that comes from now to then, we already have a solution. And His name is Jesus. Could we give Him a big clap? Hallelujah. Morning, and is it my foot hurting, man? My right foot hurting, man? Hey, don't put your focus on your foot. Put your focus on Jesus. I say like me. You see the same way it comes, same way it has to go. That's the way I know it. I went to sleep good. I went to sleep good. And the same way it comes, Lord, I am looking at you the same way it has to go. Because if you start looking at your foot, let me tell you something, you might want to come to church, but my foot out in the back. This is the problem, Lord. The reason why I can't go to church because of this. Don't put it on your foot. Amen? Put it on Jesus. You could tell me one person to have a problem. If there's one person here to have some kind of problem, let me tell you. But then you make God a liar. Everybody has a problem. Your problem might be this one problem, and that one might be that one. But everybody have a problem. But the nice thing about Jesus, he can solve everything. But you have to keep your eyes on him. I know a certain person come here and God started the healing process and the work. Healing work in their life. The process started. As soon as God started the work, somebody introduced them to a doctor. And the doctor starts saying, well, they have this and you have that and you have that. And they call me and they say, Prophet, I'm frustrated, you know. I say, why? They say, well, somebody sent me to a doctor, and then after they sent me to a next doctor and a next doctor. I respect the doctors. I am on tape right now. But what I'm saying, when they talk to the doctors, they get frustrated. They say they are frustrated. And I ask them, when you talk to Jesus, do you get frustrated? They say, no. So I ask them, who should you talk to? Talk to Jesus. Amen. Amen. Because when you talk to the doctors, you get frustrated. Your spirit gets broken down. But when you talk to Jesus, he starts to heal you. Could we understand? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. But Billy, wake up, my brother, and get up with a saxophone. Hey! Praise the Lord. We'll be right back. There is no spirit, no God, because our God is a spirit. Everybody, our God is a spirit. And when we come to God, we must come to God worshiping Him in spirit and in truth. And this morning, right where everybody stands, you can feel and you can taste and you can know that God is real. Sister Margaret, see that? Lift your hands right here, right here, right here. Because the Spirit of God is going to fall upon the power. Woo! The power of God, the power of God, the power of God. The power of God wins. And just lift your hands, my brother. Lift your hands, lift your hands, lift your hands. It's not by might, not by power, but by His Spirit. And right now, the Spirit of God, brother Winston, is upon you right now. You have somebody in the back of you. Don't worry. Just receive from the Spirit. The Word of God said, the Spirit bring life, but the flesh bring destruction. And the Spirit of God is upon you right now. The Spirit of God is upon you right now. The Spirit of God is in you and around you and over you, and the power of the Spirit take it over God. Hey, 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 hey. Sarah, lift your hands right where he is, right where he is, right where he is, right where he is, right where he is. Because the power of the Spirit of God is in this place, people. He's in this place. You know why I always tell everybody? In our churches, anywhere you go, you can find church. And there are plenty of church. And I always tell people in this church, if there is no spirit in the church, there will be no God. And if there is no God, nothing will be happening. Amen? And when I'm speaking, but nothing positive will be happening. Negative things will take place. But because of the Spirit of God, that is why people come here and they get help. And we don't have to go around begging people to come. Everybody, come on, let's be real. Let's be real. Travis, let's be real. Oh my God. Travis, I can see the Spirit of God upon you, my brother, all over you. Just close your eyes. All over you, all over you. I can see you soaking in the presence of God right now, my son. Right now. Right now. Right now. Watch it, get that. Watch it. Watch it. Watch it. Hey, my God, my God, my God. My God. My God. But Billy, we serve our awesome God. We serve our wonderful God, everybody. Can everybody say hallelujah to that? Come on, come on, come on. Can somebody say hallelujah to that? Sister Melina, right where it is, right there. The power of the risen God is falling upon you. Church here, and nothing is happening in your life, look for the church. I'll ever hear any preacher talk like that. I'll ever hear that. I'm the only one that say that, and more people just keep coming. And you don't even see that, and more people say, keep coming and coming and coming and coming. You know why? Let me tell you something. People are looking for church, they're looking for help. Because there are plenty of church. But people looking for Jesus. Amen. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Where the Spirit of God is, there is freedom. Where the Spirit of God is, there is help. Because the Word of God said, He's our helper in the time of trouble. When we call upon Him, when we call upon Him, God is good. Amen. Everybody, God is good. You may have your seats, everybody. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Good morning, everybody. And welcome, welcome, welcome. Green up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Sunday service within Action Ministries. My name is Sister Roxanne, and I'm a proud member of Within Action Ministry.
Hey! Watch the joy of the Lord. Next thing, you skip over some people and all. That's good. That shows that the church is alive. Come on, here, man. Came out to get you flip on your ear. Watch it. Praise the Lord. Go ahead, Sister Roxanne.
I want to tell you all that when you come here, keep on having the faith and expect something great is going to happen to your life. In your life, whatever you are going through, keep your faith, keep praying, hold on to what you have and what you believe in. And that is Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. She is a woman leader in Within Action Ministry. All I know is we have some tough woman leaders.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning. This is Madam Brian. Should I be husband?
In the back, straight on to the back.
Straight on in the back. Hi, husband. This is wife Beacon. Go ahead.
This morning, I just want to tell the church that I know that everybody is going through something, and I know that God is going to bring you out. Don't let the enemy steal your joy at all, because He did not give it to you. Okay, everybody, just rejoice and be happy.
I like how you do that. Put on the attitude again. He did not. Let me hear the attitude.
He did not give it to you in the first place.
Right. I like the attitude of the man. He did not give it to you in the first place. But Brother Billy. Now, Brother Billy might have to go a little differently. I'll tell you why. Because, you know, I asked Rena to show she husband this morning. But Brother Billy and the wife, so I can't say show me your wife in the convention, right? So I might have to approach you a little different. But yes. Billy, how have I been with you? How have I been with you?
God
been
what? Wonderfully good to me.
He what?
He ever this morning.
All right.
God been wonderfully good to me. He's awesome, excellent. I can say that He's awesome because situations in my life need an awesome God to show up to do awesome things.
But the situation you was talking to me about, to go ahead and solve that one already?
Oh, yes.
You got through that?
Yeah. We see,
Brother Billy had been praying for a wife, everybody. He had been praying for a wife. And that was a big situation, if you can understand. So that's why I accept the situation that we have been speaking about, if you get through. So you got through.
That is not the situation.
What?
But that is not the situation. That one is not the situation. That is one thing. In the right time, in the right moment, in the right season, you know? You see, God is moving cycles.
Steve, what do you think about this season? You think this is the right season for
you? Yeah, man.
Oh, very well.
I feel he overseas. He marinated right now. Praise the Lord. It's okay. We're going to laugh in the church, everybody. Because when you laugh, the joy of the Lord is your strength. And the church remains always excited. Amen. and power of God flow through this church. Yes,
God. Hello, Prophet. I believe in these last days we must know who our God is. Hallelujah. If we know who our God is, we will not be confused about giving God the best praise we could have. Why? Because see, some people don't know who God really is. They will cut a tree down, you know, and they will melt some stuff, and they will bow down and worship the God. Amen. So I believe just now they might, not go in some stores and buy gods. Hallelujah. But our God is not our
And you know something, I want to tell you something that Brother Belize, our sound minister, I want to tell you that, you know what, get me stirred up a lot. When people who God working in their life,
Amen.
Calling me and ask me, Jesus, for real.
My God.
I said, I have something better to do. I don't want time to talk that right now. I better you want to eat or buy something or drink or thing. I had to really waste it, you know. Because you know God, what God doing in your life and all that, and you call me that, is God really real? And they say, I ask them, I say, if you turn your back from Jesus, you have a choice. Turn your back from Jesus, where are you going? Straight to the devil?
Straight to the devil.
So, what do you go back?
You know,
God. I say, that is foolishness, man. You go ask me if God is real, go out there and see how real the devil is. And then you will know who real God is.
God declared in his word in Isaiah, I am the first and I am the last. Beside me, there is
no other.
God said, and he doesn't know any other God.
And I don't know any other God too. Not only God.
So he is the true and living God.
Exactly. Exactly.
So we are not supposed to be confused who God really is. He's from eternity to eternity.
I wonder if they know that they are alive. I don't know if their brains just live on their body. I really can't understand. I can't answer for them. I don't know if sometimes they bring the brain. Come, Brother George. Anybody can make you out anyway. The most good looking man in the church. Come in. Come right in. Praise the Lord. I'll give this man a big laugh. Come on. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Sit down. Brother George, come up here. Mr. George, come right here. Come right here. Put you where I can see you. Yeah, put you right there. Yeah. Right. And you look nice. You look real saucy in front of me. Praise the Lord. So, brother, baby, God is a good God.
All the time.
I love you, my brother.
Amen.
Hey! Hey! Put on me, my brother, baby. Steve, come take that mic from me. I want to give this man a prophetic hug. Hey! I want to give this minister a prophetic hug this morning. You know that Holy Ghost hug?
No.
Steve, you got to call him my waistcoat just like you took my shoes. Hallelujah! Come forth. Go up to Lazarus. Come forth. Come quick. Forget about four. Come quick. Amen. 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 Come on. Come on, darling. It's about time, girl. It's about the end of my Travis. Travis, give me a box. Hey, that's what you're talking about. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Just imagine. These youths wake whole night. Then I'm man, when I look and I still up and energetic, I see some of them dragging by. I said, today youths are not like long time years in a way, but they did. You know, hey, Giselle, just like a salad. Yeah, man. Hallelujah. Hey, everybody, we're going to do, surely goodness. Brother George, you want to come? What did you come to church? Praise God?
Yes, I
praise
the Lord.
Are you praising the Lord? By sitting up next to Brian's wife and only watching the lady come. The Brian in the back watching you watch. Use your brother, boy. Use your brother. Okay, let's go. Come on, Houston. Surely goodness and mercy.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life.
Last week Sunday, there was a movie down. And the church had moved down. Wow. I want to thank God for these youths. Because anyway God used them, they're just going to light up the place. And everybody wondering, where is churches? Where is churches? Amen? I just want to thank God for them. Amen. And that guy is the best dancer, that one in the Green Day. Yeah. Yeah. All right? So, come on. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Next one. We go to the next one. Amen, amen, amen. Take it up, take it up.